Today, I'll conclude the series on red black trees and explain the delete fixup method that we talked about last time. A quick summary. In the last video, I discussed transplant and the delete function. Today, we'll unpack delete fixup, which fixes any red black violations. As a reminder, here are the properties of red black trees. A node is either red or black. The root and leaves are black. If a node is red, then its children are black, and all paths from a node to its nil descendants contain the same number of black nodes. When we delete a node from a red-black tree, we may need to rebalance or recolor nodes to make sure these properties are still met. Here's the delete code. Ignore the details, I know it's small, but at the very bottom we have two lines. When our original color value is black, we call delete fixup, passing in x. I'll start by stating that we'll name x's sibling, w. Let's look at the four types of fixes we'll encounter. First, when w, x's sibling, is red. Second, when w is black, and w's left and right children are black. Third, when w is black, w.left is red, and w.right is black. And finally, when w is black and w.right is red. It's worth noting that these are not exclusive fixes, as we may do more than one fix per invocation. I'll show you that quickly in the delete fixup code, which is on the right. Again, I know it's small, and later we'll break it down step by step, but you can see by the control flow that more than one fix can happen in an invocation. I also want to point out that we call the function when the original color is black, and we also only execute the fixes when the node that is passed, x, is black. And lastly, at the very end, you can see that whatever node x is pointing to, by the end of the function, we color it black. Let's look at our four fixes, starting with type 1, when w is red. I'll note that I'm only showing partial trees for this example, since screen real estate is limited. I'm leaving off nil nodes and subtrees. It's also possible that after a fix, you may see an invalid red-black tree, since it's only one step of the process. Here's the code for type 1. We set W's color to black. We set X's parent to red. We call left rotate on X's parent. If you want a deep dive on rotation, please rewind a few videos in the playlist where I explain them in detail. Finally, we set W back to X's sibling. On to type 2, where W, W.left, and W.right are all black. We set W to red and change X to its parent. Again, I want to say that this is not a valid red-black tree. We're looking at this specific fix in a vacuum. Here's fix type 3, where W is black, W.left is red, and W.right is black. We set W.left's color equal to black. We set W to red. We do a right rotation on W. And finally, we reset W as X's sibling. Lastly, type 4, where W is black and W.right is red. You'll notice that if we do type 3, we will automatically do type 4. Let's walk through the code. We set W equal to X's parent's color, which is red. We set X's parent equal to black, as well as W.right. We do a left rotation on X's parent. And finally, we set x equal to the tree's root. Again, this by itself is not a legit red-black tree, but imagine it's part of a larger tree, such as this, which is a valid red-black tree. And that concludes our four fixes. Remember also, at the very end, we set x equal to black. I'll end the series with a reminder that dynamic set operations on red-black trees, such as searching and insert and delete with rebalancing, is big O of log n. Thank you for watching and sticking with me during this tough topic. I hope this video helps you on your computer science journey.